Space travel was very much in vogue in 1968. Stanley Kubrick's 2001 A Space Odyssey featured elegant sequences of spacecraft in flight. Roger Vadim's Barbarella featured an astronaut dressed in a bizarre array of exotic outfits. Doctor Who's last female companion of the 1960s would owe something to both these zeitgeist-defining space epics.
Well, the rocket couldn't have drifted 87 million miles off course.
So what's your theory?
With a career as an astrophysicist, kinky boots and catsuits, Sophie Harriot was a cute space oddity. Although actress Wendy Padbury would later complain that she was soon screaming like all the rest, her stories show her to be resourceful, prone to teasing the intellectually challenged Jamie, and competitive with the Doctor.
Love it. It's amazing. Even the best of our students register less than half that score.
Yes, well, Zoe is something of a genius. Of course, it can be very irritating at times.
But Wendy Choyne is known as the smallest show on Earth, because Patrick was 5'8", I'm 5'8", and Pat is with us.
There must be something we can do.
As Jamie and Zoe were sent home by the Time Lords, and the Doctor was exiled to Earth in the last episode of the 1960s, the end of Doctor Who coincided with the close of the most memorable decade in the 20th century. For the people who were there, their association with Doctor Who and the 1960s is something they'll always cherish.
I loved doing Doctor Who. I loved every minute of it. I loved working with the cast. I love working with Verity, and I loved everybody on it.
It was a swinging time, it really was. Everything was fun. There seemed to be... one didn't have to be totally responsible, you know? One could enjoy oneself without fear of retribution or anything else. It was a great time.
It was great fun. It was elating. And, of course, the miniskirts, the ones and all that. There was a sense of liberation and freedom, and I enjoyed every minute of it.
In fact, I think I can fairly safely say I was a rock chick. I can remember very well sitting on Dennis Wilson's